Hi, Jim Beckler here with the RV Corral. Hey, I've got a brand new 2018 Montana fifth wheel I'd like to show you. I'll take a few minutes to walk you around, point out a few things on this unit. You may have run out of time. Maybe you don't have the time to watch the full video, or you might have questions about something as I go through this. I'm going to try and hit some high points, but obviously you can't point out everything. You're not going to want to sit here and watch me for hours on end going through this thing. So give me a call if you have questions. 541-510-1017. You might have something that I didn't cover. You'll have a question about it. Give me a call. I'll be glad to help you out. This is a 310 RE model. This is if you're looking for something that's got a really good balance between livability and towability, this is a good floor plan. It's three slide out, so you've got a good amount of space inside. It's very comfortable when you're out in it, but it's not so big that it's a problem to pull around. So notice, speaking of towing, it's got a nice molded front cap, a nice solid fiberglass front cap, and how it's contoured on the corners. This makes it a little easier for towing. Plus, you've got your hitch pins sticks out quite a ways towards the front, which also enables you to have your actual hitch being a little bit further back from the back of your truck. So the maneuvering is a little easier. You don't have to worry about making a tight corner and bouncing this thing off the front of your truck. We always recommend you get a adjustable hitch, just in the event if you have a short bed truck, to get a slider hitch just in case you get in a tight spot. I like this too. This is a, they call Hitch Vision, Keystone patented that, and that allows you to look in your rearview mirror and catch an idea where you're at on your, when you're backing up and hooking up. Gives you a little better vision of when you're getting loaded up. They even have some lights back here. Large pass-through storage compartment. You get all that room in there. Very tall, deep, lots of storage, even finished out nice. All welded aluminum framing, heavy-duty construction, but it helps eliminate some of the weight, keeps it a little bit lighter. You don't have to worry, you know, some of these that have a lot of wood in them are a little more prone for dry rot, things of that nature. You won't have to worry about that with fiberglass, with the aluminum. Notice the welds are full welds. It's not spot welded. Every weld that you look at is going to be consistent. So it's built really well. You know, you've probably heard of Montanas or seen them out there. Been one of the top selling fifth wheels in North America for the last 15, 20 years. This one also has auto level on it, so I can level this out. When I get to my spot, I just disconnect from my truck, get my front jacks down, hit auto level, and it'll level itself out. Makes it very easy. I don't have to fight with that. Notice in here you've got your, all your hookups are right in here too, that are enclosed. So you have heated area in here. It's out of the weather. So I can hook up my fresh water connection right here. My tank poles are right here for black and gray. Everything's easy to get to. Fresh water connection right here. It even has an outside shower connection right there also. I have propane tanks on both sides. I've got one here and one on the other side. They split them up so you have a better weight distribution. You know, they really try to engineer two things in the Montana line. They really try to emphasize, one is towability and the other is livability. So they want a good balance between the two, something that's pretty easy to tow but still comfortable and have more of a residential feel than just a trailer. Let's take a look inside. Just before we go in, let's want to point out too a couple things on this side. Notice the nice big patio awning. Got a huge electric awning. I can pull that thing out and push it back, get it back in with just the push of a button. all electric, got not good lighting out here, even has outside speakers. Notice the steps, got not four steps, so I don't have to take a great big step to get in, start get my momentum going up. Even has a lend a hand to help me out there. I think you really like the way the floor plan is laid out. So for starters, got a great kitchen, nice island with dual sinks, nice stainless steel sinks, has sink covers also, so I can use this for additional counter space, nice residential style faucet. Really makes this, like I said, a little bit more like home. Nice full extension drawers, even has a little pull out for your garbage right here. Notice as I pull these out too, not only are they full extension, but they use heavy duty glides too, so this is more like a home application. The advantage of that, of course, is I can put more weight in there and I don't have to worry about this thing falling out. I can put a lot of weight pressure on that and it's not moving at all on me. So tons of drawers, even has more counter space back here, lots of cabinets. I like how this is designed too. They've got this just stovetop, has a cover that I can use as a backsplash, or when I'm not using the stovetop, I've got additional workspace here, and the oven is a larger propane oven, 22-inch oven. Nice big microwave, lots of room in there. And for those longer trips, you've got a four-door refrigerator. So you've been doing some RVing, but you want to step up a little bit, maybe spend a little bit more time. You're in a position now where you can go out for maybe a month at a time, or maybe you want to head for the desert when the weather gets cold around here. It's nice to have additional space to put your refrigerator items in, and a nice big pantry here also. Again, it's really more suited for extended travel. Lots of plug-ins, lots of drawers, very comfortable fifth wheel. Now this one has three slide outs, as I mentioned outside, so this all slides out. I've got the sofa here that's a sofa sleeper, so this will make into a bed. Got additional, they don't waste the space, they utilize the space really well, so lots of storage. Even has shelves and storage back here with the TV mounted back here on the back wall. Got windows, so you got some nice natural lighting coming in. One thing they're gonna try to do too with the Montana is they're gonna give you a lot of 110 outlets, lots of lights, that want it to be a little bit more accommodating, more like a home than just a trailer. Here's your entertainment center, it's all right in here with a glass cover, so you can use it for the remote. You could even put another accessory in there if you wanted to, but this is all set up so I can play DVDs here. I can put in a CD, and has auxiliary plug-ins too, one for headphones, one for USB. If you want to stream your own music or audio or video in there, you can. It even has the speakers. This has surround sound. The fireplace is not just for ambiance. It's actually a functioning heater. So this is an electric heater. Put out plenty of heat. You can actually heat this area in here. I think they say they'll heat up to 400 square feet. So this whole area in here, it would heat this very, very easily. Save on your propane. If you're plugged in somewhere, you can run that off electric element. Get more storage. It also has, these are electric too, and I don't have power right now, so I don't have batteries in this. We're going to put batteries in it when you get ready to take it home. But it does have electric lift on the footrest. Even has a little place in here for storage. Maybe your Might want to store your candy bars in there for when you're watching the movie right across over here. Nice dinette set up here. You've got a residential style table and chairs. These you can move around. A lot of people like these because you're not restricted like you would be with a booth. You can even move the table. It's attached to the floor right now, but it can be moved easy enough. But notice all the windows in here, lots of lighting. It's just a great layout. Even has a ceiling fan up there and a skylight, which is closed off right now, but that opens up. And you've got a nice high-speed fan right here also that's controlled right here. It's got a max air fan, moves a lot of air also. So as we go up into the bedroom area and the bathroom area, you see you've got a little coat closet here. My controls are right here, easy to get to. So if I want to kick my awning out, I can do it right here. All my slide controls are right here. Check my tank levels, hot water heaters. I can run it off the electric or the gas side. Even has a tank heater for the tank holding tanks in case you get in some really cold weather. These are 0 degree tested too, by the way, so they're already designed to be good in cold weather, but it's nice to have that additional feature as well, so it puts direct heat to your tanks. Water pumps, controls right here, lighting, everything's right here, easy to get to. And then I think that little switch is for the fan. You'll like the way the bathroom's set up. If you want to come on up here, got a huge shower. Skylight lets in natural light. Even has a little seat back there. And again, this is all ducted. You have heat and air conditioning in here. Nice one-piece countertop, or actually undermount sink. Again, more storage. Even has a little medicine cabinet. Got pull-down shades. You can see they're down right now on the sides, but you do have windows on both sides of the bed, so you can let in not only light, but those old these will open up too. So if I want to let in some fresh air, I can. And lighting back in here. Full closet. Nice deep closet. A lot of hanging space. Even has a little shelf up here. And then this is plumbed for a washer and dryer, so if I want a washer and dryer on board, I can set it up right in here, or you've got additional storage and plenty of storage there. Some people like the idea of having a washer and dryer, some not so much, so you have the option on that. Also has a nice flat screen TV back here, nice, plenty of drawers. And good window right here also, which is an egress window. So great layout, as I mentioned before. Good balance between livability and towability. Again, if you're wanting something that you can go and spend some time in and be comfortable, but you don't want a monster fifth wheel that's super heavy, this would be a good choice. 541-510-1017. Give me a call if you have any other questions or want to see what we could do about getting into it. So just ask for Jim, and I thank you for your time.